Good morning, Charging Wildcats. Today is Tuesday, March 8th, which means it's National Proofreading Day and National Oregon Day. On the main desk, I'm Corey Edwards.
And on the virtual studio, I'm Brooklyn Bonner. Today is also National Peanut Butter Cluster Day, and it is also National International Women's Day. So now let's get into our news. The big news for today is, of course, our Wildcats making it to the state basketball championship game. Yes, both of our boys and girl teams won over the weekend and will compete this Thursday. So for all the info, let's head to Sports on the Hill.
Sticking up, no rubber band is big enough. Tennis so heavy, can pick it up. Came with the gang, a myriad. I see you with hilarious. Where's my roof, mysterious? My whip from Fast and Furious. Curtains with yellow interior. I get the calm, period. Covered in ice, Siberia. I'm at the top of the pyramid. I'm strong, serious. We gonna play serious. Came with the gang, a myriad.
Hey, yo. Hey, Charging Wildcats. It's championship season, and I'm here to give you all the details. So, here's the dealio. Both championship games are this Thursday at the Hot Springs Convention Center. The girls will play at 6 against Fort Smith Northside, and the boys play at 7:45 against Bentonville. Because we made finals, we have a temporary private link open to us to buy tickets. You can only find this link in your email or in the description of this video. Tickets are $8 for adults and $7 for students. After Wednesday, the link will go public, and anyone can purchase these tickets. You only need one ticket for both games. This is a mobile device ticket event only, so no paper tickets. Lastly, remember, due to safety reasons, backpacks are not allowed. Now, for those who are here on senior night, you may remember a very special guest player, Joe Hofford. I recently got to talk to him. Here's that interview. What is up, Charging Wildcats? I'm here with the man, the myth, the legend, Big Joe. All right, so we're getting some questions down. What was it like to play on senior night?
Well, you know, Jake, if on senior night, it feels great. I thought I'm never gonna get a chance to play on senior night, but till the unexpected happened, and you know, and so when I got in, I was like, oh my goodness, about to play.
Yeah,
I was speechless at the same time, and I was trying to put the jersey on and all that kind of stuff, and you know, it feels great. And then when I got in, I missed, like, dang, I missed 4 threes.
You still got one?
Yeah, I know. Yeah. I went 1 for 7. When I made that bank shot 3,
hey man. I saw on your Instagram story the very next day. You made 3 in a row. So
yes, I did.
No fret.
Yes, I did.
How long have you been a team manager?
Ever since my sophomore year.
Awesome.
It's an all-star in football.
Oh, man, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Right. And how do you think Thursday's game against Bentonville is going to go?
Oh, man, it's going to go awesome. You know, the fans, the excitement, the cheerleaders, everything, even the basketball team. I don't know what to say about Thursday, but it's going to be packed.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be a great game.
Yes, it is. Everybody's going to be there.
Oh, yeah. Everybody will be. Even though the championship is this week, we still have other sports news. So, starting us off, the baseball team is in their preseason and will be in their conference season soon. As well, the next track meet will be next Tuesday. Next, congratulations to the boys and girls soccer teams on their wins in their first few matches. Lastly, congratulations to the swim team and their placings at their state meet. The boys placed 5th in the 200 medley relay and 6th in the 400 free relay. I placed 4th in the 200 yard AM, Peyton Price placed 6th in the 100 yard freestyle and 3rd in the 100 yard backstroke, and lastly, I placed 2nd in the 100 yard breaststroke. That's all sports news we have for today, Wildcats. I'll catch y'all next time.
We need to remind you all about all of the rules for attendance for flex. Now, if you're attending a club meeting, the club sponsor will enter your attendance, and if you're attending math tutoring, there's a QR code for your attendance.
For everybody else, if you are not going to be in your flex class to perhaps retake a quiz or work on one one-on-one with your teacher, it is your responsibility to let your flex teacher know where you are and have it confirmed by the teacher you are visiting. Again, you must confirm with your assigned flex teacher and the teacher you are visiting.
The Theater Arts Department has been working hard to bring you another great show, Puffs by Matt Cox. High school students are invited to view the performance on March 18th around 9 a.m. Tickets will be $3, and students must have their ticket the day of the show in order to be let out of class when called to the performance.
Tickets will be going on sale on Wednesday and will be sold during flex and after school. If you are planning on getting the ticket during flex, check with your teacher because the location varies depending the day and the towers in which you are located. After school sales will be in the cafeteria. The last day to purchase will be Tuesday, March 15th, and they will only sell 900 tickets on a first-come, first-served basis.
And now for this week's weather, let's go to Marisol.
Hey y'all, it's Marisol and I'm back with this week's weather. So yesterday was a little bit rainy, and with that is going to bring a cold front for the next couple of days. And Friday again, we'll see those temperatures rise up after the cold front, but Friday it will rain again, which will bring us another one. But let's hope we get back up to those 70s and get that warm weather back again. So let's jump into this week's daily forecast. Yesterday it was rainy with a high of 65 and a low of 37. Today it's cloudy with a high of 54 and a low of 36. Wednesday it'll be having a 20% chance of rain with a high of 52 and a low of 38. And Thursday will be partly cloudy skies with a high of 63 and a low of 42. As we jump into this weekend, Friday will have an 80% chance of rain with a high of 54 and a low of 24. Saturday will be sunny with a high of 45 and a low of 29. And Sunday will also be sunny with a high of 63 and a low of 43. And that's this week's weather.
Good luck to our Quiz Bowl team. They will be competing in the 7A Regional Tournament at Little Rock Catholic High School this Saturday, March 12th.
The Seal of Biliteracy is looking for new candidates this year. The informational meeting will take place tomorrow, Wednesday, March 9th, during Flex and Ms. Matthew Hicks Room, C113. It's open to students who speak two or more languages and it is interested in learning more about the Seal of Biliteracy.
Are you interested in TV production? Would you like to be doing the news like us? Then sign up for Fundamentals of TV. This class is open to any sophomore and juniors, and you will learn all the basics of what it takes to work here at NLRTV. And then you might be able to move up to be part of the crew. Remember, anyone can sign up for Fundamentals of TV.
Bone marrow is a spongy tissue inside of all of your bones. It contains stem cells as well.
December 31st, 2019, there has been 634 transplants in Arkansas.
Honestly, approximately 18,000 people need bone marrow today. Bone marrow transplant is to cure many diseases and types of cancer. Donating bone marrow is free.
Donating bone marrow is important because a bone marrow transplant replaces a patient's diseased blood-forming cells with healthy cells.
The City of Little Rock is sponsoring a virtual college fair that brings together 28 historically black colleges and universities from around the country.
Upon registration, students will receive the login information for the Hopin platform, which allows students to go into virtual booths to see live presentations and chats with the recruiters.
Included among the 28 HBCUs are Arkansas institutions, Arkansas Baptist College, Philander Smith College, and the University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff. The event will be held Friday, March 12th from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m.
Now, as we do every week, we will play the Star Spangled Banner. This time, it will be performed by Michelle Jones.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land.
And that's all the news we have for you today, Wildcats. Remember that if you have any announcements or comments, you can contact us via email at nlrtv@nlrsd.org.
And don't forget to follow us on Twitter at NLRTV4, on Instagram at NLRTV_NLRHS, and on our Facebook page, North Little Rock TV. And please subscribe to NLRTV YouTube channel.
Have a great day, Wildcats!